We're taking two of the greatest sandwiches known to mankind, the classic pastrami sandwich and the French dip, and we're throwing them together. It's gonna be good. I always say that. How can you not like a great pastrami sandwich? Warmed up pastrami, coleslaw we'll put together ourselves, melty cheese, Jewish rye, and then you take that, you crisp it up like a grilled cheese on the flat top, you cut it and then you dip that in delicious beefy onion gravy. Sounds like a winner to me. Can we start by making a little onion gravy thing that'll be tremendous? Let's go. Start with a little oil, avocado of course, follow that up, some diced yellow onion. We let that start to do its thing a bit. We're gonna let that soften about 3 minutes. Now we'll add some garlic like this. Give that the requisite 45 seconds-ish to start smelling really good. Then in goes a couple tablespoons of vermouth. 1 and 2. We'll let that do its thing. It'll start to reduce, and in about 3 minutes, when most of the liquid is gone, we follow up with some beef broth. And now, this is just gonna do its thing over the next 20, 25 minutes. It will reduce, the flavors will intensify. We won't forget to give it a little salt and pepper. And while it does its thing, we'll start on our little quick, simple slaw. Look, you could buy green and red cabbage and cut it up and add some carrots and whatever else you want to make a slaw. But when I'm in a hurry, or when I just don't want to, or when I just want to make it easy for myself, I buy an already bagged slaw. This one happens to be a broccoli slaw. I like it. It changes things up a little bit and it adds this extra crunch that is always welcome. So here we go. In goes a big handful, lovely. A little hit of Japanese mayo, tiny splash of apple cider vinegar, and then we season. First, a little pinch of salt, and then the two things that make a perfect slaw for me. One is a ton of black pepper, and in this case, a ton means, you know, quarter of a teaspoon for this little amount. And my other favorite thing, celery seed. You can hardly see it going in, but know that it's there and we'll do impressive things. And now we mix. Mmm. The celery and the pepper are the standouts. You know, pastrami is a pretty big flavor. You wanna go toe-to-toe with it. No shrinking violet slaw for this sandwich. All right. The au jus part of a French dip is typically a pretty liquidy beef broth-ish thing, which is fine. I prefer a slightly thicker version for dipping into, and we're gonna fix that with cornstarch and a little bit of water. It's very simple. Using the dirty measuring cup my beef broth was in, I'll drop in about a tablespoon of cornstarch, followed up by a couple tablespoons of cold water, and I'll mix. And by the way, when using cornstarch to thicken a broth, for example, we always add water to the cornstarch, mix that, and then add it to the broth. You would never just sprinkle cornstarch on top of the broth and try and mix it in because it'll clump. Nobody likes a clump. Nobody likes a clump. Okay, let's add this to our beautifully bubbling oniony broth. We'll pour in maybe half of the cornstarch slurry and leave it for a bit to see how thick it gets. I don't want it like thick gravy, but I do want it to have a little consistency. Now, onto the sandwich. Before I start with the pastrami, a few days ago, I was wondering aloud why the hell lemons had seeds, but limes did not. Well, Dean Uribe writes, Sam, limes that don't have seeds are simply because they do not need to be pollinated. They're considered parthenocarpic fruit that doesn't need to be pollinated, so therefore no seeds. Well, thank you, Dean, and I still think they could figure out how to make lemons without seeds. They made a watermelon without seeds. How about turning that technology to the lemon? That's what I say. Now I say, let's cut up some pastrami. So, a little piece of pastrami right here. Just some nice pieces we'll slice because we want this to be a classic pastrami sandwich, and that means a bunch of pastrami inside. So we'll cut till we think we have enough. Let's see how that looks. That looks pretty good. How's that look, boys? Good?
Good.
Pretty good.
Okay. All right. Here's what we're going to do. Let's get our sandwich ready. Let's get our bread ready. So I'll move this, wipe this down. See that? I don't know if you could roll that back a bit, but I just cut myself. The knife was here, and I went like that right in the corner.
Wipe this down. Wipe this down.
By the way, my knives are sharp, folks, so be very careful how and where you touch them. That's a huge bummer, man. And here we go. So, I've got my favorite for this, Jewish rye. And not because I'm Jewish, but because I think it's what makes the best pastrami sandwich. So we're gonna go like this. We'll start with some grainy mustard on one side. Let me spread. We're gonna put coleslaw on this side. Nice. And now the pastrami that's right here, we want to warm this up first. I want to warm it up first. So we'll take some of these slices, we'll throw them right on the flat top. So here we go. Just throw these guys on. Oops. Don't race too fast. I'll get them all a little bit of individual heat. And then we'll stack up and add some cheese. Look, this is not a necessary step. If you want a basic pastrami sandwich, but if you want a killer one, this is advised. Don't forget, it's coming back on. For the bread to get all crispy and everything. But for now, we want to do this to it. Now we'll throw a couple pieces of cheese on. I'm using Swiss. A splash of water to help it melt. And it's there, we'll pick it up, we'll put it on our sandwich. And here we go. Ow. Ow. Nice. Now the flip. There we go. Now a little butter goes on here. And this whole kid goes back on to the flat top to get crispy, golden, and beautiful. And we're down. We'll let that get a little color before we add butter to the top and then flip. In the meantime, let's get some of our dipping gravy in this little guy. Oh my God, the smell is coming out as I pour it. It's gonna be amazing. Check our sandwich. Let's put some butter on top and then we can flip. And a flip looks like this. Oh, that's gonna be good. Really good. And here we go. Hello, my friend. Let's go. And there we are. Ow. Hello, gorgeous. And a cut. Oh, hey, fellas. What's going on here? Gorgeous. And we're ready to enjoy what might be one of the greatest pastrami sandwiches ever. First, a regular bite. I was gonna go to the corner, but I can't because I have to dip the corner, so I'll go right in the middle. It looks like a cartoon picture when a little kid takes a bite out of a sandwich. Preheating the pastrami was a wonderful move. And now, turn it around. Let's get some of the gravy in on this. This is the money shot and the money bite. Here we go. Nice big dunk. Drip, drip, drip. Oh, hello, Sam. Hello. All right. That's the move. He said, with his baby finger elegantly raised, not because he's a gentleman, because he cut the shit out of himself. Oh my God, all right, make it. I always say that. Subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Tell your friends. Hit the notification bell so you don't have to come looking for us. We come looking for you. Astro!